You may just think this is another crappy Minecraft clone, but this was created entirely in Scratch. Now, Scratch has a couple limitations. Firstly, it doesn't have a 3D engine. Just be able to place these down would require a lot of work, because it just doesn't have 3D. It's not like Unity, which you can just place a cube. This thing, you need to know that a cube's being placed and actually draw each like pixel individually practically. That's why it's running so slow. So that's like the second big limitation of Scratch. It's really slow. There's this link over here, which I can just copy and paste to make it speed up. So Turbo Warp increases the speed by compiling it, but this means we can run our Scratch game heaps better. Okay, it's already smoother. It's so cool how it can just make this a 3D world. In this video, I'll show you some of the most amazing games ever made in Scratch. They overcome the limitations in remarkable ways. So this is a 3D terrain generator. See, we can move it around. You may think, oh, that's just boring. It's just gray, black, and white. Well, we can texture it. We can color it. And we've got, oh, a lot of water. We can play around with all these sliders. It's showing us a procedurally generated world, and we can actually move it in real time. There's heaps of tutorials on how to do this in Unity, like Perl and Noise, but for Scratch, there's nothing. Now, here's a game I found, Submersible. Yep, I'm just clicking until something happens. Oh, there's instructions. I probably should read those. Put that in, that in, that in, that in. Then let's launch S to lower our submarine. But look at the little details. So, it's a pixel art game. It actually looks pretty good. And there's little particles. Now, Scratch doesn't have a particle system, unlike Unity's particle system, a system for making particles in Unity. And there's little fish. So all these details actually just slow down Scratch. It really does not like it. Oh, and there's also no physics components. I don't even know how they do it. And also, there's no text engine. So you have to use the pen system to draw text or have a costume for each piece of text you want on the screen. You can't just put in a block the text you want. So we're going deep into the ocean. We're drilling for all these materials, which I didn't read the instructions to know what I'm doing with them. And oh, we're really deep now. It's getting dark. There's no lighting system in Scratch, did I tell you that? I can't just add a light and make it work. How do we get back up? Because I think I've damaged my submarine. It's got 3.4 health. Oh dear, I'm not meant to hit the rocks, but I'm hitting them very fast. I think I'm even more lost, I have no clue. Do you see that bobbing up and down? So it actually feels like water. Oh, and here's our boat. So our submarine's getting pulled out. We can get some upgrades. There's a lot of stuff. Way too much for being made in Scratch. Like, you probably could sell this or something. People would buy it. If you want to do better than me, the links to all these games are in the description. Okay, here's Google and Scratch. So let's just search for Scratch. Okay, and then Google search, page one. There's Scratch. maybe cats. Yeah, it's a bit limited. Scratch can't actually access the internet, so we just got screenshots of some random web pages. Okay, this is Google Street View. It's a bit better. Place, we can look around. We can move about. This is an actual place, and they exported 3D images, put into Blender, then found a way to render it in Scratch. So it's actually pretty cool, even though you can't like go to other places. It's pretty impressive that they get an actually convincing looking photo. Okay, you've probably seen balloons, like that tower defense game. Now, what if we could make it in Scratch, but just change it a little bit? Vectoid TD 3D. Like, even the title screen, I can just move the mouse around. So we've got three worlds, and now I'm trash, so let's play Toxic Quadrant, because it says beginner. Easy. Tower defense games are very long, so I'm just gonna rapid fire some of the features. A laser, targeting options, an acid gun, sound, oh, electro, dark matter mines, oh dear, there's regen now, flying, booster, DM fluctuator, particle, dark matter vectoid. Do you want just a reminder that there's no 3D blocks in Scratch? Oh dear, there's bosses. What if we just let it run and look inside? Okay, this is pretty small. Okay. Oh, you know it's bad when there's a lag spike opening it. Oh, yep, this is how you get 3D, all right. Oh, Oh, and it keeps on going. And it keeps going. Yep, there's still more. And there's still more. And... nope, there's more. Yep, again. Oh, I thought we were over. And surely that's it. Okay, that's it. Let's go to our costumes tab. These are all the projectiles, I think. Oh, there's another lag spike opening another sprite. Oh, it's empty. Oh yeah, speaking of empty, it's actually full. Like, chock-a-block. There's a lot of lists. Oh dear, that's a lot of variables. That's a lot of data this game is dealing with, like. Oh, and I think I'm losing. Oh good, I didn't lose. Wave 50 though. We've got the big boy. Can we beat it? Oh, that was easy. Oh no, it splits into multiple. Surely we can beat this. This is easy, 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 easy. Come on, no, don't lose. I beat easy mode on an easy map. If you can beat hard mode on a hard map, the link's in the description. It's really cool. And also, this video over here is where I react to some other impressive Scratch projects.